What is a humanoid robot? A humanoid robot is a robot with its body shape built to resemble that of the human body. Humanoid robots are generally considered to be the most advanced type of robot. This is due to the way they walk, which is known as bipedal locomotion. That is why most, if not all, humanoid robot development started from building and programming the robot legs first. Researchers know that without a stable locomotion, adding other body parts to a humanoid robot is pointless. For example, Honda began to develop humanoid robots in the 1980s, and the first few models were bipedal robots with only two legs. Over the years, more parts were added to the upper body, and the robot design slowly evolved into the ESMO we see today. Stability is a very important criteria in robot design. A robot should not overturn in any condition, unless it is an intended action. Stability can be divided into static stability and dynamic stability. To be statically stable means that a robot can maintain its balance when it is not in motion, or in other words, it can stand still without falling over. Imagine that you are on all fours on the ground. In this position, you are statically stable. You will not fall over, unless of course if someone pushes you. Some robots are designed to be dynamically stable. These robots must actively balance itself. For example, Raybert's one-legged hopper robot has to keep moving and hopping in order to stay upright. If it stops, it will fall over. Imagine riding a bicycle. When you are moving, you are dynamically stable. But if you cease pedaling and come to a complete stop, you will wobble and possibly fall off your bicycle. Thus, when you are not moving, you need to rest one foot on the ground to stabilize. A robot's stability is greatly related to the position of its center of gravity. So what is a center of gravity? It is basically the point where all mass is equally distributed around an object. In other words, the center of gravity is the point where all the weight of the robot is focused. The closer the center of gravity is to the ground, the more stable the robot will be. Thus a tall humanoid robot is less stable, and topples easily. This explains why sumo and combat robots tend to have a low profile design, which is to achieve a lower center of gravity, and hence higher stability. In addition, for a robot to remain stable, its center of gravity must be directly above its support polygon, which is basically the area that is made up by the legs. Thus, the size of a robot's base also affects its stability. A bigger base means a larger support polygon, and hence greater stability. Consider these robots and their support polygons. Robots with more legs that are set as far apart as possible are relatively more stable, as compared to robots with only one or two legs. Consequently, four-legged robots are widely used due to their high stability and do not require too many motors. When one leg is lifted up, it still has another three legs on the ground to form a support polygon. Therefore, to make a robot more stable, we need to lower its center of gravity and increase the area of its base. A humanoid robot has a relatively small support polygon, and it is even smaller when one foot is lifted off the ground to take a step forward. Nevertheless, it is possible for a humanoid robot to be statically stable while walking. The robot designer just needs to make sure that each motion frame is statically stable. This also means that the robot can stop at any position without toppling over. Yet, a robot that is statically stable when it is walking will not walk as well or as fast as a dynamically stable robot. It will not be able to run and jump too. Therefore, an advanced humanoid robot should be dynamically stable, which means it can actively balance itself, so that it does not topple when it is walking, running, or even jumping. humans are dynamically stable. We maintain our balance by distributing our body weight, so that the center of gravity is within the support polygon. For example, if a person is carrying a box, he will lean backwards slightly to compensate for the weight of the box. Likewise, when you walk, you achieve balance by distributing your weight. You do this by moving your arms and bending your knees, so that the center of gravity is always in the middle, hence maintaining stability. However, this is very difficult to be achieved by robots, or to be exact, it will be very challenging for whoever it is that is building and programming it. Now that you have a better understanding of center of gravity and stability, let's build a humanoid robot that can score a penalty kick.